All right. This is it, guys and gals. This is the culmination of several months and many years of anticipation. I've been waiting for this a long time. I know you have too. I'm sorry it's taken me such an agonizingly long time to get here. But we're finally here. The Overlord.
Well, this is it. It's up to me now. I just hope Gaw and Tad are okay. But no time for worry. I've got a job to do.
I have a feeling Gaw and Tad are going to be just fine. Don't ask me how I know that. Call it a hunch. The Overlord's palace. This is a pretty cool looking place. Nice, appropriately epic music. I'm gonna savor this moment. Honestly, I wasn't sure I would ever actually get here for a while. I mean, I was sure once I started recording, you know, this last series of videos, but before that, oh.
It is impossible to turn away now. This is your destiny, and my revenge.
Your revenge will have to wait. For as long as I hold this blade, the only executioner here will be me!
You've come so far only to place yourself in my velvet grasp. Before me, brave words turn to dust in the mouth. Hopeful thoughts wither into regret, and the confident heart melts into naked fear. Step forward then, little one. The hour is at hand.
Man, that is one poetic villain. He reminds me of, Reminds me of the soliloquy from Symphony of the Night. Velvet hand? That doesn't sound very intimidating. Okay, so this is the Overlord. This boss is kind of weird. The main things we have to worry about are the dreadful flying glove, which should be easy to jump over in theory, but I tend to have a problem with them. The only time we can hit the Overlord is when he shoots that spark attack out of his chest and reveals yet another marble mouse trackball for me to shoot with my magic sword. The reason I bought all those stone shoes at the shop is because as you fight this boss, the floor gradually becomes more and more full of spikes, but I kind of didn't realize or didn't remember that the stone shoes also affect your jumping height, so I'm probably not going to actually use those. My main strategy in this fight is to switch to the amulet whenever possible, which is often. If you do get hit by the dreadful flying glove, it can either grab you, or you can just kind of graze the back of it and it damages you. The best thing that can happen with the glove is for it to actually grab you, because you have plenty of time to get into your menu and switch out to the amulet, so you don't actually take damage from it. Crap. Okay. Well, that's what we have. See, it has me in its dreadful clutches, but once I switch to the amulet, you know, I'm totally safe. We do, I think, 2 points of damage with every hit, so it's going to take quite a few hits to actually whittle him down. I expect that. I mean, if this fight takes too long, then eventually the whole floor will just be nothing but spikes, at which point the stone shoes will be helpful, because we can actually stand on the spikes, and we can still jump high enough to deal damage to them. We just can't jump high enough to dodge the gloves while we're wearing the shoes. I mean, it's possible, but it's much more difficult. We have him down a pretty good bit already. He's down to 67. The boss doesn't do much more than this. Or does he? I know these kind of epic final bosses always have you know, second and third forms that are like way more deadly than what you have to face in the first form. So I guess we'll just have to wait and see what the Overlord has in store for us. Whatever it is, I'm sure it's going to be much, much more deadly than the stupid glove. I mean, come on, what kind of attack is that? He shoots his glove at you? I mean, he doesn't even have hands. I mean, I guess he's shooting his hand at you. But I mean, his hands are invisible or non-existent until he spawns one specifically to fly at you. Just kind of a goofy boss design, I think. Come to think of it, the last boss didn't really have limbs either. This game has a lot of floating torsos in it. Crap. Alright, so I think we have two elixirs left. I should check just to be sure. Oh, one. Okay. Well, we better, oops, I should have used an apple there instead of a banana. Oh, well. Alright, 37. We've got him, pretty far down. I almost used another banana, but luckily I had full health, so it didn't do anything. Alright, let's see if I can move to a part of the level that has a little bit more surface area. I guess really, the far left and the far right sides, oh crap, are the only place where there's a significant amount of floor left. Can't really hit him when he's off the screen like that. Oh yeah, I didn't do any damage because I still had the amulet equipped. Oops, crap. This final boss music is pretty good. It's nothing compared to that level select music though. I mean that, aw man. That was the best music in the game. Alright, one elixir. We still have plenty of fruit, so we don't have to worry about that too much. We still have plenty of amulets. In fact, it's probably, I probably went a little overboard on the amulets. Okay. If you stay still. Damn it. Come on, you jerk. Expose your weak point. You're a boss, that's what you're supposed to do. Alright, I'm actually out of elixir, so I'm going to go on ahead and try to keep my health up. I have him down pretty good. He's at a quarter of his maximum health. I should probably just keep the amulets equipped all the time, except when I know I can get a hit in on him. I know it's not fun to watch me pop in and out of the menu like that. Or maybe it is fun, I don't know. But, needless to say, if it weren't for the amulets, I would be pretty screwed. Oh, dreadful flying glove. You're so dreadful. Alright, 16, so 8 more hits, I think? I think I'm doing, I don't know, it seems like okay, 3 damage per hit. So at this rate, I'll have him down at about 5 hits. Really don't like that animation on Popful Male when she's grabbed, when her eyes bug out like that. I mean, it's painful to watch. It looks like it really hurts. You know, as opposed to everything else in this game. Alright. Almost got him. Oh crap, I fired the wrong way. Good job, Duke. A plus video gaming. Alright. Alright. I was just kidding about the second and third forms. There's nothing. It did heal me up though, which is nice. It'll help me fight. Question mark? Alright, enjoy the cutscene, guys.
Hey, let me out of here, you morons! Do you know who you're messing with?
Oh, pipe down, you old windbag. Mel and Tad will deal with you when they get back.
I hope they're alright. You made it back alive!
The Overlord is toast!
And, speaking of toast, what are we gonna do with the old Muttmeister? I say we seal him here in the Orb Tower and let him rot!
Why would you want to do a thing like that? What have I ever done to you?
Now that the Overlord's been destroyed, I say let him go.
Maylee, did you hit your head or something?
Yeah, Mel. Remember, he's got a pretty big bounty on his head.
Let him go.
What a bunch of chumps! Now it's time for you simpletons to suck the sour wine of my discontent.
I ain't sucking nothing.
Well then hold on, it's going to be a bumpy ride.
The only bumps here are going to be on your head after I throw you over the railing.
You and what army, Chia Head?
Now stop it!
Oh, I don't mean it. All I ever wanted was for people to show me a little respect, but all I can seem to manage is to make a mess of things. Oh.
You once taught me it is never too late to change, right?
Oh, Tato, I'm through with all of this. I'm going to retire. As for you, Mel, through the great doors over there, you'll find Kaiser's secret vault.
But...
Take what you want. I've lost my taste for treasure, and after all that you've been through, you've earned it.
I actually really like the ending theme music, so I'm just going to let this play. Talk to you in a few.
Upon the farthest star.
All right. That was nice. And that is it. Popful Mail concluded. No new game plus or anything. If we continue, all that will do is, you know, load one of our old saves. Okay, so a few final thoughts about this game. I know I've grumbled about it a little bit. I've been a little hard on Popful Mail, and I feel kind of bad about it. I do like this game. I wouldn't have started to LP it to begin with if I didn't like it. From a gameplay perspective, it's not the best game I've ever played, obviously. It's interesting. But, you know, I think the localization, you know, as goofy as it is, it's really the best part about this game. Yeah, it has a bunch of dumb, corny, you know, dated 90s jokes that are totally anachronistic for this kind of game. Not even anachronistic, I don't even know what the word is. Inappropriate? But, you know, as dumb as it is, it does make you smile. The characters are really likable. In, you know, in their own goofy ways. I do like Popful. I like the team. You know, the character portraits are really well animated. They look really good. And, you know, for the time, a game... I hope that wasn't too loud. But, I mean, a game localized from Japan with that amount of voiced dialogue, you know, it was pretty... pretty unprecedented for the time. I wish I played this in 1994. It probably would have blown my 9-year-old mind. I really enjoy Popful Mail for what it is. It's a flawed game, but I still like it. And, you know, if they were to do a Kickstarter for a Popful Mail sequel that had all of the original voice talent and, you know, the same writers and the same localizers and everything, I would pay $15 to download a copy of that game and to back the Kickstarter. Obviously, that's never going to happen, but, you know, yeah, I like it, and I hope you guys liked it too. Huge thanks to Kim, who donated for me to play this game. I'm very sorry it took so long. I hope it was worth it in the end. Your donation helped me out during a time that was very difficult for me, and I do super, super appreciate it, and I appreciate all of the other donors too. The next donation game will be Dungeon Hack, and that will either be Let's Plays or done during a live stream, whichever the donor prefers. I'm going to have to ask him about that. After that, we will have Super House of Dead Ninjas, and DMC, the new Devil May Cry game, and finally Undead Line. And I'm pretty sure that's it. I don't think I'm forgetting anyone. If I am, please let me know. So yeah, look forward to Dungeon Hack and all the rest of those games coming soon. And I will see you all next time. This has been Popful Mail. I'm Duke of the Bump. Goodbye.